everyone, welcome to Frock Up Friday. It has been a big week, a tough week for a lot of people. I hope you're all hanging in there. I hope you're all feeling okay. There's been a lot to absorb this week. Not all of it good, definitely not. It's an interesting state of affairs at the moment. Our heart goes out to everyone who's being hit this week, basically. We hope that you're all doing well. Hang in there. We hope right now that you're kicking back at the end of the week with a soda water or a glass of wine, just letting it all wash away and taking a few moments for yourself tonight and joining us on Frock Up Friday. Styling session, fun, fashion. So that's what we're going to deliver you tonight. We really just want to support you in any way that we can. And we love our little Friday night styling sessions, and we know you guys do too. So we were going to style puffer jackets tonight. We haven't done a session on that yet. We are due a session. They're a huge, huge, huge vibe every winter. They have been for the last few years. And we thought it was really important to do a styling session on them. There's a lot of you out there that have embraced that trend and are rolling with it. And then there are a lot of you out there that wouldn't touch it with a barge pole because you just don't know what to do with it. And it feels like it's not a very versatile trend. You know, you're thinking active wear, sports wear, lounge wear, that's about it. So we want to give you a heap of different ideas so that you can get heaps of wear out of your puffer jackets, because they are a total vibe. They're everywhere at the moment. They will be season after season after season because they're so convenient. They are so warm and so comfy. So we can't see that trend going anywhere anytime soon. So we thought we'd rather give you all the information so you can embrace it. And then the other thing we're going to have coming up soon is a trend I said I would ignore and never, ever, ever embrace. And I jumped online last night and I've ordered. It's not the sort of trend that you would spend money on. Personally, this is my personal opinion. It always is on these Friday night sessions, and you guys sometimes agree with me and sometimes not, and that is the way of the world. That's exactly how it's supposed to be. All of us having different opinions and different values and different perspectives is what keeps the world spinning around and makes it so beautiful. So I love being proven wrong, go for it. But in my personal opinion, I wouldn't spend money on this type of trend because I don't think it's going to be around forever and a day. I think it is one of those very strong trends that people will grab hold of. It might be around for a couple of years and then it will die in a ditch. Some of those trends even die after one season. So, and that is combat boots. People are loving it. Some people are hating it with a passion. So I ordered a couple of cheap pairs online last night. They're due to arrive on Monday. And what I'll do is show you, and this is a really fun take on a styling session for us, because you know we're all about supporting the brilliance of the Australian fashion industry and buying well, buying once, buying key, timeless, beautiful pieces that really showcase the design prowess and abilities of our fashion houses here in Australia, and loving them and wearing them and getting that joy and that buzz out of wearing them for years and years and years to come. That's our ethos, that's our style, that's what we do at Miko Mollie. And we don't really buy into the fast fashion trends because they're bad for the environment and bad for your wallet, to be honest. They just sit in the wardrobe and you barely wear them, and then you throw them away at the end of the season into landfill, or you donate them, which is the right thing to do. But also they're often really cheaply made and they don't stand the test of time. You know, you cheap $30, $40, $60 t-shirts, they start peeling or they lose their color after a couple of washes. And I always maintain that buying an item like that doesn't give me that same thrill and buzz, and it's not something I think about and invest my time and energy and money into. So I'm not emotionally invested in those pieces, which is why they sit in the back of the wardrobe, because I'm not inspired to bring them out and craft an outfit from them. But also I don't value them as much. And so I learned a really long time ago to invest my money into pieces that I do value, that I am connected with. And then I find that they inspire me. They make me want to create beautiful outfits. They make me want to play with my wardrobe and create something incredible and walk out of the house going, yes, like, this is amazing. I love this. It showcases who I am, and I feel proud and beautiful and creative and strong and bold. And that's what my wardrobe does for me. So I learned that lesson a really long time ago. So one of my practical rules is on these cheap trend items, especially if you love it, go for it. But there's always a way that you can wear it with those beautiful pieces that you have invested in. So go cheap on the trend items, invest in beautiful, timeless quality, amazing design, things that are so wonderful that you're not ever going to get sick of them, that you're going to get heaps of wear out of over years and years and years. And so that's what I'm going to do with combat boots. When they arrive on Monday, we'll schedule it in. I'll actually talk to you guys about it and see whether or not you want to do puffer jackets first or combat boots worked into all of the wonderful things that you buy from us all the time that we have in our wardrobes. So we can work in a fast fashion trend item sort of thing into our more timeless, beautiful Australian designer wardrobes and see what we come up with. So I think that's going to be a really fun session. But tonight we came up with something fun because of the news everyone received this week, and it is depressing. It's sad, people are angry, there's lots of emotions, all of them are valid, absolutely, regardless of what anyone's opinions are, everyone's emotions and feelings are valid, and we just wanted to have a little bit of fun and take people's minds off of it tonight, and do a little bit of lockdown dreaming. So we are here tonight to dream up the most fabulous outfits for the end of lockdowns, regardless of what your occasion is. I've just pulled a heap of things from the store. They're piled around me. We're just going to play and have a little bit of fun. We're going to dream up some of the things that you're going to do after lockdown. Go out for a fancy dinner. Go out for cocktails with the girls. Go to a family barbecue or a gathering. All of those beautiful things that we love doing, that we're going to dream up, and I'm going to come up with some like fabulous dream outfit that you can lust over for the entirety of lockdown. And I hope that just gives us a bit of fun to do tonight, and I hope that inspires some fashion thoughts instead of other thoughts, and is something that helps get you through. And that's what we love to do on these Friday nights as well, have a little bit of fun. So I'm just like pouring my eyes over all this stuff. It's so wonderful. Like, I'm feeling excited and happy, and I hope you guys are too. I keep plucking at my hair because it's going to end up a mess like it always is. I don't know why I bother wearing it down when we have these styling sessions, but I thought I'd do it nicely for you tonight. Last week was a messy old bun, so we've gone for straight, and it was shiny and smooth for about 3 seconds. So let's get started, shall we? Fabulous out there, extra outfits for post-lockdown, whatever the occasion might be. I'm going to throw together some of the most fabulous items that we have in the store at the moment and just inspire a bit of energy and fun and excitement. And we can marvel on how incredible our Australian fashion industry is through all of the trauma and just horrendousness that has been the last 468 days or whatever it is now. We are still able to produce this sort of quality in one of our key industries. It's amazing. We all need to pat ourselves on the back. And lots of industries are pulling through and getting things done in crazy circumstances that no one's had to encounter ever before. So that's amazing. That is so amazing. Look what humanity is capable of. I'm just so proud of the adaptability of businesses and industries and markets, which includes you guys, the consumer. This is the economist in me talking now, sorry. It's incredible, and we shouldn't lose sight of how much we've all achieved in the last year. So well done, guys. Please spend some time reflecting on that tonight or over the next few days, because we do need to focus on some of the positives at the moment, because it is getting a bit tough for some people. So let's get to it. I am wearing from the latest Camilla drop, the Fitzgerald's flapper twist front, split front dress here. So I know we'll take this off in a second. And of course I'm wearing the incredible center back layer that everyone has been talking about, with all of the beautiful beading down the back here. This is a key piece. It is a really exclusive piece, actually. Not many of these were made. And we're lucky enough to have it in our store, which is incredible. So I've layered that on over the top because I did tell you I was going extra. Look at this. And of course, if you want to be super, super extra and really celebrate the end of lockdown, headwear is a must. We spoke about that last week or maybe a couple of weeks ago now, that headwear is coming through super strong for the winter season this year. It is about being luxe and extra and embracing it, and embracing color, texture, silks, knits, lots of beautiful fabrics, and just going wild. So that's what I've done tonight. I've just laid myself head to toe in this incredible Fitzgerald's flapper print with all these beautiful emerald greens and gold, and I feel incredible. And this is the point. This is what we're doing, is talking about the power of a wonderful outfit and how it can change your mindset. It's exciting when you start pulling it together. It's exciting when you put it on your body and you transform yourself and feel amazing. And it's even more exciting, I guess, when you receive compliments on your creativity and your styling. And people go, wow, I would never have thought of putting that together. Like, it feels good, guys. So I really want to give you that opportunity to lean on the power of fashion while things are feeling a bit shitty in the world at the moment, and see what it does for you, because it definitely does that for me. So yes, I'm feeling very extra, very incredible. This dress is funny because it's like, it's a suit, it's really smooth, like a jersey fabric, and you can't help but want to touch yourself, which is also very interesting. So, you know, it's a good choice for tonight, I think. I'm loving it. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And of course, I've got the brand new, just released Black Luxe heel, super, super embellished. I'll take one off for you here. So you can look at that. How can anyone have a bad day or feel shitty in a heel that looks like that? Honestly, incredible. You wait till you see the boots. They are amazing. So I've gone with the heel with this beautiful dress. It does have a very feminine silhouette, like it follows the body here. So I thought I'd go with a heel, a blingy heel, and really dress it up. So this outfit is our post-lockdown dinner outfit. Treat yourself to some amazing restaurant that you haven't been before. Head out with your partner or your friends, and just really enjoy it for what it is. And I don't care if you're overdressed. Walk into that restaurant overdressed. Who cares? This is your life. You live it your way. And if dressing like this head to toe and going out for dinner post lockdown makes you feel incredible, who is anyone to stop you from doing that with their opinions or any other way that I don't care what they think. So here we go. That's our fab first dinner outfit out of lockdown. And I'm loving it. But let's mix things up a little bit. Oh, I've just popped my turban out here. And I will show you how to do the turban. If you want me to show you, I have done it a couple of times for you guys, but if you do want me to do a quick refresher tonight, I certainly will. But let's run through a couple of different options. So we've already got this dress in our wardrobe, got the beautiful layer, we've gone super extra tonight. Let's go like first girl's lunch out post lockdown, or winery tour or something, or even like just pick a winery, jump in the car with the girls, drive out to it, have a long lunch, buy some wine, bring it home, continue the party on your lounge room floor. Although if you've been in lockdown, you're probably sick of the sight of your own home, but bring that joy back into it as well. Like that, I think that's one of the disappointing things about restrictions and lockdowns, is that some people have gone crazy and remodeled their homes. I know I did a lot of that right at the beginning last year, but other people are sort of feeling like they're locked in, like their home's become a prison. So try and bring some of that joy back into it if you can. So for that girls' weekend out of the city or out to a winery, long lunch, drive back with your boxes of wine and then have a little picnic on the floor. I mean, no one feels like a second dinner after a big lunch like that. So cheese platter on the floor with some wine and your girlfriends will be amazing. So for that, we're going to use the exact same dress, the one that makes you feel like an absolute fox. It follows those womanly curves. It's beautiful and stretchy. It's design brilliance, and this is why I get so excited about the fashion industry. It's a lot of details that I know a lot of people miss, and I always feel really bad for the designers because they put so much into every garment. The design of it first, then the fabrics that they choose to use. Some of them even design their own fabrics, like Camilla, for example. It's incredible, and every detail is deliberate. And this dress is super deliberate. The V neckline to draw the eye down to the center here. There's gathering and a twist, which is to disguise any parts of your body around here that you don't love. So despite the fact that this is a fitted dress and follows the line of the body, all of this gathering and twisting and bringing forward here confuses the eye. So it's just looking at the dress. It's not looking for any lumps and bumps. And the lumps and bumps are all disguised here. And then follows through the hips and line of the legs just beautifully with a gorgeous draped sleeve here to add a little bit of drama and again more femininity, I think, as well. So it's just a stunning dress, and you've got it in your wardrobe now because you've just worn it for your first dinner out. Now we're going away to a winery for a boozy lunch with our girlfriends. So we're going to throw on the Second Skin Blake biker jacket, and we're going to take off our glam heel, and we're going to street style this dress up just a little bit to match our leather jacket. So we are going to go, I'll put my socks out of view, we are going to go with an ankle boot. And if we're going to go with an ankle boot, we're going to go with the queen of all ankle boots, the brand new Black Luxe Camilla ankle boots. This is selling out nationwide. Everyone's already sold out of size 36 and 42, I believe. It's only the middle sizes left. It is conservative Euro sizing, so whatever you are generally in European sizing should be perfect in this boot. Unfortunately for me, I generally am a size 42 in most European shoes. So that it is pretty right for me. They are slightly more generous than last year's boot, I personally feel. But yeah, whatever size you had, if you bought them last year or whatever you're wearing, European sizing should be right. So there we go. We've just funked up this gorgeous dress with this great split, great for photos, definitely. It's in the perfect placement. Again, like I said, perfect design. So you've got this beautiful split, you've got a great biker boot down here with incredible embellishment, real standout boot. You've got the Blake biker jacket on, and you can take or leave the turban. But this is my afternoon out with the girls, fancy little winery lunch, or even a pub lunch where you really want to, trust me, you're all really going to want to get dressed up and head out after lockdown. So go for it. Who cares what anybody thinks? There's no such thing as being overdressed. It's just being dressed how you want to dress. And I'd definitely throw on the Dylan Kane wax bag as well, because I love this bag. You can carry it like a little clutch, perfect for that, or you can lengthen the strap out and pop it over your shoulder to carry all your belongings while you're heading out with the girls. So there we go. That's that one. You already know, I probably won't show you again, but you already know I adore the zip front dress. So I've just got that one here with me to show you as well. Laid under the matching layer, or worn exactly as I've done it here with your black ankle boot, your black leather jacket, a turban or no turban, and again for that sort of more casual girls' day out look, which can go straight through to dinner and afterwards as well. That's the beauty of dressing like a queen. Or you can pair it back with the black luxe heel as well and a turban and really dress it up. This one can go as far to formal as you like. So absolutely adore all of those. They would all be on my post-lockdown list, as would be the new navy luxe turban. If you don't want to fold your own turbans, this one comes pre-made for you. Stunning embellishments all the way around. A perfect little pick-me-up for anyone who's needing it. Okay, let's keep moving. I did bring the caftan out here too, but I have done a styling video on the caftan only in the last 7 days or so. So maybe we'll do that at the end if we get time, but if not, I can just repost that one up for you. Next, we have an exclusive little knit that only arrived today, actually. It is Fitzgerald's flapper, but it's obviously running a little bit late. So it only arrived today. I haven't had a chance to put it online for you yet, but I will do that tonight. And I'm going to style that up for you. I don't think it's even on the Camilla website yet. So That is pretty cool, isn't it? You guys are the first ones to see it. So let me pop that on for you in one of my next post-lockdown outfits, and we'll style that up a bit and have a bit of fun with that too. So I'll be back in 2 seconds. Okay, here we are. Isn't this stunning? Look at it. Isn't that amazing? And look at this beautiful sleeve detail on it as well. And it's a slightly bell sleeve. It is just stunning. I'm obsessed with this knit. I bought one similar last year and I wore it to death. Obviously not to death, it's still in perfect condition because it's great quality. But yes, I'll definitely be grabbing one of these this year because I got so much wear out of it last year. So here we are. I'm going to slip the heel back on because I love a great mule heel with a great pair of pants, especially these leather joggers. I've been wearing mine to death recently and I do have a couple of other little looks to show you with this one. Excuse me, I've been talking too much. So I've just front tucked this beautiful little Fitzgerald flapper V-neck tunic, it's called, into the Ginger and Smart collected leather jogger pants, and I've popped that beautiful embellished mule heel back on for like a sleek black on black look. Like, this is fab. Guys, I'm going to throw it out to you guys now. Post-lockdown, where would you be wearing this outfit? I would wear this to the supermarket to do my shopping, to be honest, after lockdown. Well, I think this is a great pub outfit, especially if you're going out with friends. Can start as like a kid-friendly pub lunch, and then maybe negotiate with the partners and kick on with the girls afterwards because you are totally ready for it. So I'm loving this sleek black on black look. It's a little bit casual, a little bit chic. So it'll do so many different things for you. It kind of does double duty there. But let's like kick things up a little notch, shall we? Because I did promise you lockdown dreaming outfits. This is about like getting our imaginations running and just like delving into the world of fashion and losing ourselves for a few moments tonight. So I'm going to throw on the Unreal Fur Fascination Jacket, aptly named. Just to show you that brown and black can definitely go together as well. I find myself leaning on this color combination quite a lot. especially all of these mocha furs, the Unreal Fur, Fur Delish and the Fascination, both made from this mocha, have lots of tones through them. And we've spoken about that before. The ends of them seem to be like a super dark brown or almost a black even. So they do pair back with black really beautifully. So look at this. How fabulous is this? And the last piece that I would add on to this is obviously the Dylan Kane wax bag, just because then you've got a bit of black on the outside as well as the inside. And I think that just ties this whole outfit in beautifully. And it is all about bag positioning as well. I think it's so elegant having the bag slung over my arm like this with this particular outfit. It's just added a little bit extra detail up here. It's got the beautiful gold strap and ties all of that in. So I love this. This is one of my favorite outfits actually. So beautiful and warm, so extra. This is really like a woo, I'm out of lockdown sort of outfit. So it's a celebration outfit. I'm vibing this so hard right now. You could definitely wear the ankle boots with these pants as well. Let me just take this jacket off here. It's quite warm in here actually. You can definitely wear the ankle boot. My golden rule, and it's only a rule because then it makes it really easy to not stuff it up. You can play with it and use your own judgment. But generally my golden rule is don't let your pant hem touch your shoes, no matter what they are, and then they'll always look fantastic. So as you can see here, I've got a mule on, so there's naturally a gap between the start of the strap and the pant where my ankle is, which is awesome. So you don't have to worry about it with shoes like this. This is why heels generally always look great. But with an ankle boot, I'd just be hoiking my collective pant up, and you can do that. It is a drop crotch pant, so you can hoik it right up high on your waist and just create a bit of extra ankle there, and then you can pop an ankle boot on and just make sure that that pant's not sitting on or over the ankle boot. And then you can get away with that too. But you can definitely also rock this with a sneaker. Any type of sneaker, just go crazy. And just rock being totally relaxed, luxe, exactly who you want to be for that day. Just embrace it. And I love a look like that as well. So next up, I'm going to, what are we going to do? Maybe cruise the harbour with the girls, but it's winter, so it's a bit chilly. So, one of my fave looks, you know I love a caftan tucked into a pair of pants like a top, and you get this beautiful billowing of fabric down each side, the high-low hem, so heaps of drama at the back, and you can drop it off one shoulder, and you can have some big drop earrings on if you like, or you can wear it just straight up like a normal tee would sit. I would be rocking the turban again with this. Like I said, we're cruising the harbour, we're out with the girls, finally. The navy would look incredible on this, but I don't want to get makeup all over it. Whereas the scarf, which I threw over here, is mine, so I can get as much makeup as I like on this. So you're going to get a quick tutorial on this scarf styling. And I think I remember saying last time, bring your part back to center if you can. Have an even amount of hair on each side. Whether you're wearing your hair curly or straight, this trick always works. Even amount of hair on each side. And then you put your triangle to the front. Bring the sides up and around. Try and keep some of your hair out of the way as you go. It just makes it a little bit easier. Twist over once. As you twist over the second time, pick up that lost little middle bit there and bring it with you and make sure it's caught up in the twist. And then I've been having trouble with my turban, with this particular scarf actually, recently. So I've learned to just keep twisting a little bit so I get all of the ends trapped nicely, which is probably a good tip actually. I've never had that problem before, but it might be the length or it might be the way I'm folding it. So tie the ends at the back, try and get some of your hair out of your face, and then you just go through a little process of
neatening that up a little bit. This side's not too bad because I twisted it well. And then your little loose ends at the back come up to the sides and just tuck in, being careful not to undo the neatening that you just did. Sometimes it's a little process of neatening and untucking, neatening again. There you go. So I'd definitely rock the turban if I was going out in the harbour or boating or cruising with the girls, because it's a little bit of extra warmth. So, which is always nice, I think, to layer things up a little bit. Now, I remember the other day, I think we were talking about, last week it must have been leather jacket styling, and I said leather with leather is tough to do. It is tough to do, but I think this is one of the outfits where it does actually work, and I'm only forcing myself to do this, and this is a real life situation here, because we don't all own 48 different colours and styles of jackets. This is why winter can sometimes be a bit tough, and your styling, your wardrobe can be tough, because the jackets that you've had in the past are non-wearable anymore. Maybe they're old and don't look the way they used to. They've reached the end of their useful life, or you don't like them anymore. We always find we struggle for jackets in winter, and that's why I always tell you guys the best jackets come early in the season, March, April, May. Always snap them up because they do, and you will be kicking yourself when you get to the June, July, August, we're freezing and you don't have anything to wear. So we're fortunate, we actually bought a lot of Unreal First stock, so we've got some left heading into these cold months, which is amazing. And we got a recent top up of our leather jackets. So leather is amazing, it's a go-to, it goes with pretty much everything. And I think I said last week, the only thing that it kind of trips you up with is leather on leather. But I also said one of the best tricks is layering over it to get some real separation between the leather down here and the leather up here. So let's just throw that on, only because the two Unreal Fur jackets I've got out here doesn't really go with this particular outfit. So I'm going to lean on my leather jacket and let's see whether or not we think it works. What do we think? Am I getting the thumbs up? Push your little love hearts because they float up my screen if you like the leather on leather look. There we go. Oh, there's definitely a delay. So I think this look works, and I'll show you the other Unreal Fur jacket I've got and why I've chosen to lean on this, because you'll see that the other two jackets I've got here just wouldn't quite work. They're not the right colours. If you find yourself in that situation and it is time to rock our post-lockdown events and parties and dinners and lunches and boat cruises and winery trips and all of that sort of stuff, a long layer between your leather pants and your leather jacket will do the trick. It's going to keep you nice and warm, layer on layer, going to look fab, and allows you to get away with that leather on leather. So there you go, hot tip from me. Next, we're going to go with a slightly more casual look. And I know I did say that we were going super extra post-lockdown inspo, just go crazy, go extra, celebrate, go wild. But this is a look that I've been rocking a lot over the last month or so. And I think I just love it. It's so easy. It feels so good. It's so appropriate in like lots of different situations. So I wanted to share it with you guys, because it's fun. And so it is slightly more casual, a bit less extra, but let's do it anyway. So I'm just going to duck over here for 2 seconds. Okay, so this isn't the whole look. I'm just showing you. This is the new P Nation Destroyer sweat. And I've got my leather pants on again. And I've just switched for a white pair of sneakers here. And I love this. This is comfy, warm, looks super cool because you've got your leather pants on and a sweater, some sneakers. But this is the look that I've been rocking, and it's been totally appropriate for almost everything. I did a trip out to the Barossa the other day to spend some time with my family, drink a little bit of wine, visit Maggie Beer's farm, and I wore this exact outfit, just a different sweater, I think it was. And it was totally appropriate for everything we did all that day. And I was comfy. I have three little nieces. I was able to run around with them and do everything that they wanted to do and still look like appropriate at all the other stuff we needed to do. So here it is. My fave coat. You know I love this one. This is the Unreal Firm Madame Grace. I'm obsessed with this coat. And I have been rocking leather pants, sweater, Unreal Fur jacket religiously for about a month now. I'm obsessed with this combination and I just keep switching it up. Different jacket, different sweater, leather joggers, leather leggings. So there you go. How cool is this? It's so warm, it's so comfy. It's really like letting a little bit of my own personal style and flair show. Every time you do it, like sweater, faux fur, leather, sneakers, every time you do it, the combination that you put together just like lets a little bit of your own creativity shine. But it's kind of like a template. This is like template, This is like template dressing. Leather pants of some description, a sweater of some description, a faux fur jacket, preferably a long line. It's like that trench coat look that gives it such a cool vibe. And a pair of sneakers, job done. Literally cannot get it wrong. So I am loving this. Okay, but let's wind things back a little bit for 1 second. I've shown you a few really extra outfits. I've shown you just like one of my faves at the moment. And now we're going to make this lockdown appropriate. I know, we don't want to think about it. We don't want to talk about it. Let's pretend it's not happening. We're talking about our dream outfits for post-lockdown. But let's have a little bit of fun with lockdown. You know our 1 hour of exercise a day that we're allowed when we're in lockdown, within X kilometers from your house and blah, blah, all that stuff. we're about to do it in style. So, be right back. Here we go. This is our brisk walk lockdown outfit. Even a mask can't ruin this vibe. This is so cool. How cool is that? I absolutely love rocking this one as well at the moment. And I lived in this combo last year when we were actually in lockdown. I constantly walked Miko in a similar jacket to this, the one they did last year, which was leopard, not snake. And I didn't even care if anyone was looking at me like I was a crazy person, because it was warm. It's like wearing any big warm jacket, and it gave me that opportunity to get dressed up for the day, get creative, throw a few things together, and then go and walk Miko and enjoy some normality, and some time with my dog outside of the house and stop him from going mental. So yeah, this definitely helped get me through lockdown. So I wanted to share this little combo with with you as well. If you've got the jacket in your wardrobe, you may as well be using it, girlfriend. Getting a bit of joy out of it. So, and these are my absolute favorite track pants at the moment. These are the PE Nation Trailblazer. I wear these everywhere. There's a bit of a meme going around at the moment and it says, my wardrobe is worth thousands, but I've worn the same black leggings 9 days in a row or something like that. And that is definitely me with these track pants. I was actually a little bit worried about pulling them out for you guys tonight because I pulled them out. They were like crumpled in the bottom of my wardrobe from after my shower. So I had to steam them. And I, as I was pulling them up to steam them, I was thinking, I bet I find like big patches of red gum wood dust because I was literally wearing them to move firewood this afternoon. So to my surprise, there was no red gum dust all over them. They are actually magic. I have worn them a lot this week and they still look brilliant. Very, very good quality pair of track pants. They literally go with everything and they make me really happy. And I never thought I'd say that until this year. I was not a track pant person. I'd wear sweaters in that occasionally. Even then, I wasn't really much of a sweater person. I think COVID's definitely changed our attitudes towards loungewear. And I'm really into loungewear now. Previously, it was never something that I really had in my wardrobe and not something that I would lean on when I went to get an outfit ready to go somewhere. And now I've fully embraced it. I love the comfort, I love the warmth, and I love the surprise factor of pairing things like this together and just putting something completely unexpected together and being like, yeah, this is really cool. I absolutely love this outfit. And I feel great in it, and that's the aim of the game. So I hope I've given you heaps of ideas tonight in terms of post-lockdown celebratory outfits, a little bit of lockdown inspo for your hour of exercise or whatever your jurisdiction is allowing you to do at the moment, and get out there, rock it, get a little bit of normality back into your life until such time as this is over. And then we're gonna go crazy. So I hope you've enjoyed that, and hit us up if you've got any other suggestions for other sessions, or if you're getting really bored in lockdown and you'd like some extra sessions thrown in for the next week or so, more than happy to help you guys out with that. We'll do anything we can. We have the girls on the chat, up to 16 hours a day, 7 days a week to help you out with your online shopping. So if you have any questions, sizing, styling, please hit them up. They're more than happy to help. We know how important it is to stay connected and to feel supported during this time. And that's exactly what we're here for. It's a customer service based industry. If we're not here for that now, what good are we? So I hope you've had a good time, guys. I hope you're enjoying your soda water or your wine. You certainly deserve a wind down this week. So really relax into it. Take a bit of me time and enjoy yourselves. And as per usual, every Frock Up Friday, we have a little discount for you. And I haven't even got the new Camilla tunic up yet. Sorry, that's like a side note. And that will go up tonight. But we have 20% off of almost all new season Unreal Fur jackets, including my fave, Madame Grace, the fascination jacket you just saw, and all of the shorter ones as well, like the Snow Leopard, the shorter version of this. They're all 20% off until midnight tonight. No code required. They're already discounted on the website. And some of them are selling now Australia-wide, so you do want to get onto them pretty quickly. Plus, if you buy them now, you've got the rest of winter to absolutely enjoy their warmth, comfort, and total versatility. So I hope you guys go and treat yourselves. I hope you have a beautiful night. I hope lockdown is kind to you and you're kind to it. And we'll see you again soon. Mwah!